Have you heard? Marcus and his pirates were taken out by the Royal Navy.
So, he even got Marcus's crew now.
Of the four pirate kings who terrorized Midgand, only Ifrid and his crew remain.
Aren't the seas still swarming with pirates?
Only small fry that rob small civilian ships on the sly. But the only pirates left that can pick a fight with the Royal Navy and win are Ifrid and his crew.
In other words, the only ship left that's truly free is the Von Eltia.
For a merchant, you really seem to like these pirates.
He may be crooked, but money's not all he's after. If profit was his only desire, he could have made more by selling us out.
But that'd be too boring, don't you think? The fun's in making a killing by breaking the rules.
You're a funny guy.
And that's why Ifrid goes through him whenever we need to dock here.
Well, I can't say I've ever met a human like him.
Wind's kicking and the tide's flowing, and we're stuck here.
Then why not just set sail?
Not going to happen. The Abbey hasn't given us permission yet.
And we would need their permission, why?
The Kingdom keeps a strict watch on harbors and sea routes. It's like they've erected walls and gates in the sea.
Aha! Midgand is spread across a number of islands. The sea is the only way to get from one place to another. If they can control the ships, they can control the flow of people, goods, and even information.
Exactly. They even created that fortress, Vortigern, to help them do just that.
It's restrictive, but it's also necessary. Demons are out at sea too, and exorcists are the only ones who can stand against them.
Even still, it rubs me the wrong way. A sea dog obeys nothing but the winds and the waves.
Crabs are amazing, right?
Oh yeah! They're delicious, boiled or grilled! Even their innards are yummy! And five sets of legs, that's so many!
That's all true, but what really makes them amazing is their miraculous ability to regenerate. They can detach their own legs when a predator attacks, which lets them get away.
It's called autotomy.
And then, not long after they detach their leg, a new one grows from the stump!
Really? So you're saying we need to catch lots of crabs, then scare them so they detach their own legs?
That's exactly what I'm saying, bro. We can harvest as much as we like. No one's thought of this before. We're geniuses.
Huh. I never knew that. I thought only lizards could regrow a lost body part, and only their tails.
Lizards? Do you think Dial's tail can grow back?
If it does, we could make a killing by selling Dial tails.
Would they be tasty?
No idea.
Ugh. No way. Aizen told us to come see you. What's all this about a scouting ship?
We're going to explore the outer seas. Oh, let me explain. Beyond the reaches of our kingdom lie vast, open oceans we call the outer seas.
And you're going to explore them? What for?
To make a map of the whole world, of course.
A map of the whole world?
That's right. Ifrit's pirates have many ambitions, one of which is the creation of a complete map describing the whole world. In fact, the Von Eltius already sailed all the way to the far continent for that very reason.
That's amazing!
You guys sure dream big.
I still don't get it.
Yeah, me neither. A map of a bunch of places nobody cares about? Big deal.
Well, regardless, if we're going to find anything in the vast waters, we'll need a lot of luck. We'd like to borrow some of yours.
And just how do you plan on doing that?
I want you to use your gut instincts to tell us where to look. In exchange, the Von Eltia will be at your service. And you can keep anything we find in our explorations. You'll be able to assign us new orders from any location by using a kind of messenger bird called a Sylphjay.
Who knows? We might even come across some good treasure. Or maybe some rare food. Or brand new recipes.
That's a lot of treasure you could find.
Doesn't sound bad to me. It won't take much of our time, and besides, it could be interesting.
You're right. Okay, as long as I'm not responsible for how things turn out, I guess I can help.
All right, then I'll tell you what you need to know.
Scout ship setting sail. Take a look at this.
So now we just wait for news.
Who knows what we'll find? A sunken ship full of treasure, maybe?
Underwater ruins? Desert islands?
New shipping lanes, perhaps.
Some fish would be enough for me, especially if they sell well.
My thoughts exactly! Tuna or yellowtail or sturgeon!
scouts have reported seeing a powerful demon. Its danger level has been classified as Code Red.
Understood. I'll notify the Abbey we have a Code Red demon in our midst. Send out an emergency alert to the neighboring areas.
Right!
With wild demons this close to the capital, the Abbey must have had its hands full.
Aizen, what did he mean by a Code Red demon?
It's like a most wanted list for demons. From the latest I've heard, there's around 10 such demons across the territories.
Oh, they sound pretty tough.
That would be putting it lightly. Suffice it to say, you wouldn't want to face one unprepared.
Then we'd best be prepared.
Let's get going. While we're wasting time here, the Abbey is digging in.
You said you heard about Ifrit on the prison island, right?
I heard an exorcist legate named Melchior took him away. I don't know anything beyond that.
Neither do I. What about you, Mogilu?
Word is he was taken away about a year ago. Caused quite a stir, if I remember right. Everything about him was kept a tight secret. No one even knew what cell he was in.
Ifrit is an ordinary human, right?
Yeah. He doesn't have the abilities of an exorcist. And he isn't a demon either.
Weird. I mean, if they were just trying to bust up his gang, why capture him but leave the crew free?
If not his gang, what business does the Abbey have with him then?
We've cast our nets wide and can't come up with any explanation. We'll free him, though. His place is on the sea with us.
And you're convinced he's still alive?
They wouldn't have any problems killing a pirate who caused them trouble.
If the Abbey took him alive and for questioning, it means he has something they really want.
But he isn't the type to change his ways or bend his knee on anyone's orders.
He holds his own tiller.
Precisely.
Wait, you're coming too?
Why did you come back to us?
I could tell you all missed me something awful.
We didn't, at all.
And what about your search for this traitor?
He slipped away yet again. I've no clue where he ran off to.
You're a witch. Can't you use a spell or something?
My spellcraft works kind of like a three-legged race. It simply requires my backstabbing, slippery accomplice.
Like a con artist needs an accomplice.
I am not a con artist!
I'm not going to help you find your traitor, you know.
How cold! Such an icy stare could freeze fire!
And you don't have anyone else?
Well, no.
Do you have a home to return to?
Nope.
Do you know a trade other than magic?
Nope.
What is it, Lafayette?
Mogilu's story made my chest feel funny. And my nose is runny.
The witch has no friends, no home, and no purpose. I think what you're feeling is pity.
Pity?
It's when you feel sorrow for someone else.
I pity Mogilu.
Oh, come on!
Those walls, they're so huge.
That's Logris, the capital of the Empire. They keep demons out by enclosing the city within a great wall.
Humanity has achieved great things on the backs of slave Malakim.
Why the surprise, Lafayette? You've been here before, right?
I have. But back then, I was not who I am now.
I see. Tethered Malakim aren't even allowed the freedom to observe their surroundings.
We'll soon lose such freedom ourselves.
Huh?
We've reached the heart of the Empire and of the Abbey. Soldiers and exorcists are stationed all around. This is no place for a collection of villains like us.
I'm not looking for a place. All I need to find is Artorias. That's it.
I'll finish this quick.
It's okay.
Ready to die? Think you can dodge? Just try. Perfect mayhem.
That's all.
Two, three.
I wish I had power like that.
I'd forget about it if I were you. An inspection.
They won't inspect everyone. Just act natural.
Your face is all stiff.
I know.
You, in the black coat. Show me your documentation. Well? Your travel permit from the Abbey? Where is it?
Foolish girl! How many times have I told you? A magician's apprentice must wear a pleasant grin.
Magician?
Verily! I present to you the traveling troupe of mischievous misfits known across the land as... Muggyloo's Menagerie!
Entertainment for the ceremony?
Why, yes, indeed we are, my dear. Please pardon my uncouth apprentice. Girl, allay the good man's fears and show him the dove trick you've spent all these weeks on. Go to!
Huh? Oh, sorry, mistress. I forgot to prepare.
You pathetic little shirker! A proper performer is perpetually prepared!
It's fine. Doves flying around would be a nuisance.
No, this will not do. If you cannot summon a dove, then act like one. Act like a dove!
Cool.
Remember, Muggyloo's Menagerie manufactures mirth! That was just a small sample for the good citizenry of Logris.
Hey, you can't advertise here! Move along!
As you say!
That was a fine ploy, Muggyloo.
Well, don't expect tricks like that every day. Coo-coo. Murderous gaze! Cuckoo!
Those doves were amazing!
Just a crude trick. If anything, it just shows the capital's defenses are pathetic.
More like it shows how much confidence they have in those defenses. How many soldiers are here, Lafayette?
The number of exorcists in the capital? At least 1,000. And 2 divisions of guards.
I'd expect no less from the capital. They're not careless. They're covered.
We need transit documents.
See how the citizens smile? To think they were fleeing from demons just a few years ago.
To hold an observance of this scale shows just how much peace their power has brought.
A peace paid for with Luffy's...
Velvet?
The Abbey's job is getting harder and harder. We've all got to give them our full support.
Let's backtrack a bit. Just what sort of organization is this, Abbey?
You're kidding me. How do you not even know that?
The Abbey is part of Midgan's Church of the Empyreans. Originally, it was an order of paladins and warrior priests devoted to exorcising evil.
Yeah. The Abbey's official name is the Exorcist Abbey of the Church of Midgand. Nowadays, its members are all called exorcists.
I'm impressed. You've done your research.
So basically, they're just one branch of the church, right? For a side branch, they don't really strike me as humble.
Of course not. The High Priest entrusted all his power to the Abbey's leader, Lord Artorias. He's effectively retired.
So the Abbey's leader is at the top of the entire church.
That's not all. The Prince also gave Lord Artorias authority over all military and government affairs during the crisis.
Lord Artorias commands Midgan now, and has formed a new theocracy to combat the demon blight.
And that is the origin of the Holy Midgand Empire. The Abbey is its foundation, and its ray of hope.
Wow, okay, got it. The Abbey's a big deal.
Right now, Prince Percival is the one ruling Midgand. He's the Crown Prince.
The Crown Prince? What happened to the King?
The King is in good health, but he's decided to withdraw from public life and leave the kingdom to Prince Percival. He declared that a new way of thinking was needed to save the world from this crisis.
This King sounds like quite the guy.
Prince Percival is incredible, too. He's following in the footsteps of the King by working hand in hand with Lord Artorias in the Abbey. As long as we have Lord Artorias and Prince Percival, the future of Midgand is bright. Ask anyone.
Got it. So all of Midgand is on Artorias' side.
Sure they will, dear. People are saying it's going to be a very important announcement about the Abbey.
I want to see the exorcists! We need to thank them for saving us from the demons!
You're right. We all have to show them our gratitude and help them however we can.
Yeah! I'll follow the rules, too. I won't be selfish.
They sure are popular.
Because these people don't know the truth.
You think that's so? That the exorcists are fighting the demons they themselves cannot. That's why the people support the exorcists.
Midgard!
Listen to those cheers. The royals sure have these folks in line.
Subjects, may I have your attention? It is I, Percival Asgard, Crown Prince of the Midgand Empire. His Majesty, my father, and I are pleased to celebrate with you on this auspicious day.
The ceremony started. It'll be impossible to slip in now.
After the opening, 10 years ago, our kingdom faced an existential threat, both from demons and the terrible spread of demon blight. However, one man raised a miraculous sword and stood so that the body and soul of the land
over there
would not be lost.
You can climb up if you want, but attacking now would be suicide.
And the name of that man was Artorias Colbrand!
Artorias! 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 Artorias!
None here, I trust, are unfamiliar with Artorias' noble act. To bring us salvation from demons, he sacrificed everything.
But he's a murderer.
He called Lord Innominat, one of the five Imperiums, and blessed us with the strength of the Malachi.
But he's a murderer! Velvet!
He serves as a shining beacon of reason in this world of turmoil. And reason is what binds us.
But you killed him! You took everything that I loved!
So raise your voices in praise to Artorias' devoted work, to the Savior who purifies evil and guides our flock. Let us call him our Shepherd!
Shepherd Artorias! Shepherd Artorias! Shepherd Artorias!
Shepherd Artorias!
Even though the world was filled with suffering, I had to ask something tremendous of you all. I entrusted you to endure the pains of reason. I asked you to bind yourselves with shackles of your own will. For the only blade that can expel calamity is one forged from unshaking reason and the iron will to do what must be done. And now that very blade stands ready before all of us today, I offer my body and my life in service to the people of this great land. With the blessings of the Imperium Innominat, I will guide you to a world without calamity. And this world's suffering will be nothing but a distant memory!
But you're the one who murdered.
Fool, I'll see us.
You're the one who killed Lafayette.
What?
The Shepherd Artorias. That's who you're after?
Aw, and here I was hoping you'd just straight up pounce on him.
That would be certain death. No, I need a sword of reason and will. That's the only thing that can kill him.
Killing Lord Artorias. Playing it safe? Boring! Regrettably, it is at this juncture we go our separate ways. I've got a bit of hunting to do.
No one's stopping you.
Goodbye. Farewell! May your days be fruitful and your nights tormented!
If our enemy's calling himself a shepherd, he won't be going into hiding. Let's take this slowly.
The old man behind him. Melchior, I take it?
Yeah.
Let's gather information on these people. If we know what they're planning, we can find a weakness.
They're the most powerful men in the land. If we're going to look into them, we need a lead first.
Aizen, do you have any underworld contacts in the capital itself? Like your friend at the port?
I don't go inland much, I'm afraid. But Ifrid has close ties to a shadow guild. A tavern in the city, run by an old man called Baskerville, serves as a front for them.
A shadow guild? Those sorts of things actually exist?
That settles it. Let's head to that tavern. They'll have food, I'm sure.
Why not?
My stomach made a weird noise.
That's another sign that you're alive.
Shepherd! Savior of mankind who guides us through the darkness! What an appropriate title for Lord Artorias! I believe in him. As long as we have Shepherd Artorias, we'll make it through this era of disaster.
Shepherd Artorias?
How pompous can you get?
Artorias has already seized control of all religious and secular power in Midgand. But now that he's taken on this new title, he's no longer just an authority figure. He's become the very hope of the masses.
A dangerous opponent indeed.
After seeing that, will you still fight him?
Of course I will. He could be a god for all I care. I'll have my vengeance, no matter what.
What'll it be?
Some food for the boy.
Mabo curry is our specialty. It takes a week to stew properly.
Mabo curry?
Some of that, then. Say, do you know a man named Baskerville? I heard we might find him here.
That old man? A scoundrel and criminal who went against the rules of the Abbey. They executed him long ago.
Oh.
Velvet! This Mabo curry is amazing!
You get along so well. Is he your brother?
No.
No, he wouldn't be, would he? After all, your brother was murdered before your eyes.
How do you know that?
The shadows watch those who flinch from the light.
So the guild is still active, even after Baskerville's arrest?
That's right. Just like how Ifrid's crew continues their piracy, even without their captain.
So you're the contact?
What may I help you with?
I want to know what Artorias is planning.
Information such as that? It won't come cheap. I have here a list of jobs, not one remotely legal. Take care of all of them, and I'll tell you what you want to know. Take this with you as documentation. It's fake, but it's a good fake. It'll hold up to inspection.
It's registered to Mogulu's Menagerie.
Oh? Was that not the name you gave to the guard at the gate?
I can see you're a group to be reckoned with.
Report back here once you're finished. However, be aware that should you fail...
Then this conversation never took place. Got it. I'll cause you no trouble.
I appreciate your understanding. You're welcome to stay the night, free of charge. Forget about work until the morning comes. Right. You're missing Captain Ifrid. the captain has done much toward our viability. I promise that I'll share anything I hear about him for no charge.
Thanks. All we know is there was a pendulum on the ground at the last place he was seen. And that Legate Melchior is connected to the captain's disappearance. How? We don't know.
Sounds like you've got problems of your own. Do you really have time to take on ours as well?
I could ask you why you've tied yourself up with Velvet.
Me? I've got a debt to repay. Without her, there's no way I'd have ever found my blade again.
A demon repaying a debt? Ridiculous.
As ridiculous as a pirate Moloch, you think? No matter how you look at it, there's nothing reasonable about our rogue existence. And in this brave new world governed by reason, a rogue can either rage and become a monster like me, or...
Or band together with others. Like a ship full of pirates, perhaps.
Exactly. I admire Velvet's courage, squaring off against the whole world on her own. Few can accomplish that. It takes strength. Real strength. And I'm curious where it comes from.
So you're doing it for your...
Is that so wrong?
Same. I need allies on my side, with the strength and courage to combat this so-called order imposed by the Abbey. But anyone who's willing to put up with the creed folly of Ifrid's pirates... has to be an even bigger fool than we are. So I'm like you. I want to know how deep her foolishness...
You know.
It's a compliment. Fools that big aren't born every day.
Uh-huh. And I imagine your dear Captain Ifrid's much the same.
Aye. That man flies his fool flag proudly.
The Shepherd Artorias, hmm? He's got the populace eating from the palm of his hand. I wonder... Just how deeply will the fangs of our would-be tragic heroine scar this broken world of ours? I've got a traitor to find, but in the meantime, this should be a good show.
A scholar missing on the road to Gallus Lake.
Strange request.
If they know where he vanished, why don't they just look for him there?
Exactly. And what's so illegal about a missing persons case that you gotta go to the underworld?
I can think of a few possibilities. But our job isn't to ask questions.
A kind face for such a hard woman.
She knew about me and our cover. She's got ears everywhere.
And that's not all. She called the papers fake, but they're not.
So she's got spies working on the inside, too.
I heard that her predecessor, Baskerville, was a monument against authority. To think he was executed.
They've lost their leader, but remain unconquered. Not an organization to trifle with.
That's how they have to take on the Abbey. We'd better succeed on our missions, and not just to get the information we need.
Yeah. Besides, I'd like to get another of those drinks, too.
You're a man of taste. That place always has the best.
You'd better work hard, too, if you want more Mabo curry.
I will.
You can't stop bounce.